a very powerful idea to think about how much time are we aware, or how much time am I thinking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? And a good way, a technique, if you want to use that, I mean, pretty much everybody has phones now, you can create reminders for yourself at random times, you know, once per hour, what have you. Just have a quick reminder, it will pop up, say, what are you thinking about? Right? It will be interesting to see. I mean, if you can't be aware, and a reminder pops up on your screen, and then you say, what are you thinking about? And this is obviously very beneficial from a worldly perspective as well, because you will start noticing some sort of patterns, right? So some of the things to think about are, what are you focusing on? So if you see those type of reminders popping up, and you ask yourself, hey, what am I usually thinking about, right? Am I thinking about negatives around me? Am I thinking about my expectations that are not being met? Or am I thinking of all the beautiful positive things around me, right? Am I appreciating the moments, right? So this is again a very powerful thing to think about, that everything that we have, like basic things, we don't own them. I mean, we don't have a right over them. If Allah were not to give us these clothing, you know, fruits, food, water, clean water, you know, comfortable environment to sit in, comfortable temperature, like we don't have a right on these things. These are all, and we know many people who are just like us, they don't have these things. So if we were to appreciate those things, you know, we would be much more happier than what we are today. And using this thing of being aware of what you think about would help you realize that, look, okay, fine. So if I'm focusing on negatives, if I'm always focusing on my expectations that are not being met, yeah, I won't be happy. So maybe I just need to change what I'm thinking about, right? Am I thinking about hope, right? Hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make things happen for me, things will get better, or am I thinking about the negatives, right? We have this in Quran as well, the shaitan promises you poverty, calls you towards fahsha, indecency, right? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises you and calls you towards forgiveness and his jannah. So what is it that I tend to focus on? And what are my concerns? Am I trying to think about pleasing the Creator, or am I most of the time worried about pleasing the creation? And not just one, like whole bunch of different people that I want to make happy, that I want to be liked by, and so on and so forth. Because if that's my focus, then it's very unlikely for me to be happy, because everybody would be different, it's hard to please people, and so on and so forth. But if I were to focus on Creator and my own actions, my own akhlaq, my own contributions, it's much easier and simpler to be happy and also be successful. And so on and so forth. So it's interesting thing to think about, how much time am I aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How much time am I concerned about pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala versus pleasing people? So try it out, inshallah you'll see some interesting results. Another angle is basically loving each other, or loving only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and hating for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this comes as a consequence of us being focused on the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So once that becomes a focus, then anybody who is trying to do the work of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trying to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trying to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a natural effect would be that those people would be the one that we would love. And people who are trying to oppose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trying to disobey him, so on and so forth, naturally we would not have love for those actions. And a beautiful saying here that okay, this is by Umar bin al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. He has said that, reporting to from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, there are some people among the slaves of Allah who are not messengers, and they're not martyrs, they're not the shuhada, they're not the anbiya, nor are those shuhada. But in spite of this, their proximity to Allah is envied by the messengers and martyrs, right? Their closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And who are they? So the companions asked the Prophet of Allah, who are they? And he replied, they are people who loved each other for the sake of Allah, with no relation of money between them. So it wasn't the worldly gains or their own worldly desires, but for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By Allah, the faces of these people are light. They stand on pulpits of light. They will not be afraid when others are. They would not feel sad when others do. Then the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam recited the words, أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Indeed, verily be aware that the allies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have no fear of future, right? And they have no huzun of what has happened in the past. So this is the state that they will achieve.